it's very beautiful play, and thank you for pinch hitting today. I know you weren't necessarily prepared to play in class. I appreciate that. Do you have another copy? So you have one. And Miss Penny's asked me not to wear a mask, just for speaking purposes, and so I'll just stay at my piano and try not to get too close to you. It's really beautiful, and I know that we don't have a lot of time left to work on. What I enjoyed about the playing is it's really beautifully internalized. I think emotionally you really connect with the music, and you choose sonorities and timings that I think are very personal to you, and I think for the most part I like a lot of the things. I'm not sure, you know, there's lots of different ways of interpreting it. Maybe there are some tempo relationships that I might feel a little bit differently about, but in general, I really like the way that you think about the music and the way that you feel the music. So, are there any particular things that you would like to for me to address, since we don't have a lot of time?
This.
Okay.
I always have trouble deciding, or sort of pinning down temperament, and in regards to phrasing and tempo and everything.
Okay, that's one place that I would have liked to ask you about anyway. One interesting thing about this piece, I mean, since we kind of get there, for a movement that's written in C major, there's very little that's actually in C major. Why does Schumann do that? Have you counted, I mean, how many actual measures there are in C major? It's not a lot. And you eventually kind of arrive at C, but of course he's setting up the dominant to F. There are no real C major parts. We have the legend part, but that's in C minor. We don't get C major until the very last page. And so the whole first movement is this searching, this yearning, this sense of ecstatic longing, you know, that's very Schumann-like. And even the choice of intervals, you know, all the passing tones, there's that sort of intensity about it. So when you get to this tune, this is where I think you could have a little bit more of a sense of relaxation, a sense of calm. Now you have all these, all the syncopations, and in my ear, it got a little bit. So I think I would feel.
Thank you.
lose track of where you are if we're not really thinking harmonically. So if you can keep track, F goes to G, which goes to C, which then goes to F. And that can create the direction in the phrase if you just keep that in line. There are other places where I thought maybe you could think of that. I'll get to it in a second. But all through this, I thought this was beautiful. Does that answer your question about this part?
Yeah.
Can I ask you to back up to when you... So why do the listen for, and then maybe you're already aware of it, the G, the A flat, the G, and then you have a G sharp, an A natural, a B, B natural. And so all of that is holding all that together, and I think we've got kind of pieces in there. So can we try from... intensity. But when you expect surprise takes us completely new world. You know, we're wiring A flat, setting D flat, and D flat's the equivalent of C minor, so you couldn't get any farther away from C minor even there. Can you? Yes, I think grouping them would help you find the line. Going to here and then to here, and then up here and up. Right? But if, I think you have to have some sense, and he even writes a little hairpin. It's an emotional thing for Schumann, so you can help us find those kinds of things. I wasn't sure about the tempo. That seems awfully fast for in tempo. So maybe not so quick on that, just making sure that. And then when you get to the triple forte again, I thought the sound was a little bit aggressive. This piano, you know, you just have to make sure that when you... that you're not so... hard in the attack, and then also the release. So it doesn't get too clangorous. How are we doing on time?
3 minutes.
Okay, so at the very end, where's the... it would help us find all of that as one gesture. I didn't think your mezzo forte had enough sonority. Yeah, and adagio, what does that mean to you? How fast is it, or slow? What's adagio? Okay, adagio, you know, we think of it as slow, I think it literally means at ease. So it shouldn't be too slow. Something like that. I always think it's interesting that he writes pianissimo, that part, but then when you... Such a great feel for this piece, and I enjoyed listening to it very much.
Thank you.
Thank you.